Welcome to the Tool Review Channel. Today we're taking a look at the Irwin Vice Grip Automatic Wire Strippers. Now, if you're not really familiar with automatic wire strippers, these don't really require any crimping dies or crimping holes. These automatically self-adjust to the wire you are trying to strip, and it'll automatically strip it for you. So to start off the video here, you can see you have the traditional blue and yellow Irwin Vice Grip handles. You got the Vice Grip name stamped or embossed into the handle right there. And then you come down to here, you have some of your crimping dies right here. And then the other handle, you can see you have the lettering in yellow, and this tells you the different sizes that all of these different crimps can do. Coming up to here, you can see you have a fairly small cutting edge right there. And then coming to the main part of the tool, you have an adjustment screw right there. You have this little plastic stop right here as well. That is for if you want to strip a certain length of wire. You can see you kind of have a little like measuring table right there. It's a little hard to see with the spring in the way, but you do have a little bit of a measuring table down there. So this guy kind of flips up and it allows you to set a length of wire you would like to strip. So it'll go all the way in to about, if we can get it to go in a little bit further, it'll go into about there. And then you kind of have to pop it out, but it's a little bit of a stiff mechanism I found. And the one complaint really that I've heard about this tool is this guy does like to break off a lot. So I just keep this guy out of the way right there. And you have your jaws up here, which holds one end of the wire, and this one holds the other end of the wire. And then when you push down, it just pulls the insulation off the wire. And then coming to the back of the tool, it's fairly simple. Obviously, this tool is made in Taiwan right there. And you have a little warning up here. Obviously, don't use it on a live wire. And then the Irwin Vice Grip name right there. And I believe that is the model number right there as well. And then back to the front here, you can see. And then you see all your different crimping dies down here. So for your insulated terminals, your blue, red, and yellow, you would do those up there. And then you have a bunch of non-insulated ones and some other ones you can use down there as well. So go ahead and zoom out here and get to some of the functionality of the strippers on here. If we can, you know, strip some wire here, we'll see what we can do here. Just zoom out just a little bit further. So we're going to first start off with some 18 gauge solid wire. So we're gonna go ahead and put that in there, put that in the tool, and see how well we can do. And as you can see right there, it stripped the wire off. You just gotta pull off the final piece of insulation right there. But as you can see, it can strip a single piece of 18 gauge wire, and we'll go ahead and test that cutter out right there as well. And as you can see, it has no problem getting through that solid 18 gauge wire. So now we're going to step it up and we're going to bring in some 14 gauge stranded wire. So go ahead and put that in there and we'll crimp down on it. And as you can see right there, it pulls off that insulation, no problem. And it's not really, I can't really say it's doing a clean strip, because all it's really doing when you're stripping wire is it's just tearing that insulation off. See if we can get a close up here for you on the camera. But as you can see right there, it has no problem stripping the wire, which is great. So we'll go ahead and set that off to the side, and we will bring in some 12 gauge stranded wire and see how well we can strip that. We'll go ahead and put that guy in there, and we'll pull off that insulation. As you can see right there, does a fairly decent job, but I did end up damaging some of the wire on the inside of the, obviously the wire right there. I ended up damaging some of the strands of wire right there. And if you want to do that, you can back off the tension right here so it doesn't bite as hard or pull as hard. You can back off that tension right there, which is kind of nice. So we're going to bring in some 10 gauge stranded wire right here and see how well we can do that. So we'll go ahead and put that on the side. We'll go ahead and pull that off. And as you can see right there, no damage was done to that wire right there, which is nice. So it does work with quite a few ranges of wire. Now we're going to bring in something that I'm hoping this tool can strip with. We're going to bring in some thermostat wire right here. And this is 18.5 thermostat wire. So there's 5 18 gauge wires on the inside. And we're going to see how well we can strip off the insulation and see if we damage any of the conductors on the inside of this cable or wire, whatever you'd like to call it. So we'll go ahead and put it in there and we'll go ahead and pull it off right there. And then we'll pull that guy off. And as you can see right there, if you have the tension right, there is not really any damage done to the insulation of those wires there on the inside, which is nice. And now we're going to see if this small little cutter can cut through all of these 18 gauge wires. And as you can see right there, it is able to cut through them, but it is a little bit small, so you kind of have to have it centered. And also, there's this little piece of fiberglass insulation or whatever the heck it is, a little fiber insulation there on the inside that it did struggle to cut through as well. So I'll go ahead and set this guy off to the side. Now, one thing that I'm really interested to see and if we can ship with it is some Romex wire. I think the opening is big enough, so we're going to go ahead and grab some 14-gauge Romex wire right here and see if we can ship this outer insulation off right there. And so we'll go ahead and put that guy in there and see what kind of damage we can do here. See if we can get that insulation off without damaging the conductors there on the inside. And as you can see right there, you're able to pull off that insulation and it exposes the brown paper, and your conductors there on the inside don't have any damage done to that insulation, and there's no damage done to your ground wire right there as well. So that is super nice. So we're going to see how well we can cut this guy off. I'm not sure we're going to have too great of luck doing it, since it is three wires at once, and they are a little bit thicker gauge than the 18 gauge wire. As you can see right there, we are able to cut it off. It's definitely not the cleanest cut, but you are able to cut it off right there. So we'll go ahead and set that off to the side right there, and we'll bring in our final wire right here, which is some 12-2 with ground Romex, and see if we can strip this guy off no problem. And then we're going to see if we can cut the all three wires at once. And as you can see right there, we are able to cut off that outer jacket no problem whatsoever. And now we're going to see how well we can cut with these. I don't think we're going to be very successful with it. As you can see right there, we can just barely get it under the cutting edge right there, but we're going to go ahead and give it a try. And as you can see right there, you are able to do it, but it isn't able to cut through that insulation all of the way. So you're gonna have to either rip that off, and obviously you can see right there, it's definitely not the cleanest of cuts right there, but it'll do it. So overall, these are they're an okay wire stripper. Obviously, the name does sound nice. You know, it's an automatic wire stripper. There's no guessing involved. And you don't have to worry if your pair of wire strippers doesn't have the right stripping hole or stripping die on it. This will strip a wide variety of wires. Now, the problem I see with this tool is it's big and bulky. So if you're working in a tight space, this really isn't going to be your friend. Especially if you're working on, like, you know, a system, like for me, I do residential heating and air. So most of the time, you know, you're working in tight spaces or you're working with existing wires. So if you're getting into a disconnect box, maybe you're replacing a unit, or you just need to rewire something. This is kind of big and bulky, so you're not really going to be able to get this in. Maybe strip that one wire. It just feel like a pair of wire strippers would do a lot better than this. It's just a big and bulky tool, and it takes up a lot of space in your tool bag too. You know, most tools, they are stored like this, but obviously you can't store this tool like that since it has that spring right there. And then obviously this little plastic piece right there is kind of annoying. As you can see, it's a little bit stiff to operate and get to work right, I would say. And it would have been nice to see them maybe not have that, or make it out of a different material, because obviously plastic, it's going to get old and brittle over time, and then eventually it's just going to break. But other than that, that's really about it for this Irwin Vice Grip automatic wire stripper. You should be able to pick these up anywhere that carries the Irwin Vice brand. So I believe Lowe's, you should be able, definitely able to pick this up on there. And I'm sure there's a bunch of online retailers that you can pick this up and order it from as well. But that's really about it for this video. So if you have any questions, comments, concerns, please feel free to leave them down in the comment section below. And if you are new to the channel and you would like to see more content like this, please consider hitting that subscribe button as well. It would definitely help out the channel a lot. And also, if you want to help out the channel some more, please consider giving this video a thumbs up as well. But that's about it for this video. So thank you for watching, and stay tuned for the next video to be uploaded.